groups of infantry, it'll take care of it.
Very nice. Let's go for a ride for a minute. We'll just buzz around, and then I want to go up in the Little Bird and do some crazy flying for a minute. You want to add some more targets out there? We can go out.
What's up there?
That is correct. They have the integrated loadout editor, so it's a scroll wheel option. Takes a little, couple minutes to actually figure out how to use it, but very, very easy tool to use once you figure out how to do it.
Yeah. So Jerry, here's what he's talking about. We've got all of our different types of weapon systems. We can scroll down and select what we want to put. So if I want to go on pylon one, no weapon. What do you want on the outside? We'll put a rocket pod there.
Yeah. Go ahead and do the flechette rounds. So you got to do the rocket pod first.
Uh-huh.
Put a rocket pod in the weapons, and then click on the rocket that we're going to use. And then to the right, you'll see the dashes. After you select the rocket, you click the dashes and then click the bays where you want the missile to be loaded or the rockets to be loaded.
Let me just clear everything real quick.
All right.
Let me know if we're clear. I can't see outside.
Hold on one sec.
No, you have to hit load with everything clear. Oh, click the boxes, and then you'll see no missile or no weapon.
Yeah.
And hit load, and that will get rid of all. That work for you?
I don't know. I can't see outside. Let me see.
We still got rocket pods on the outside, missiles on the inside.
Okay, so.
That's alright. We don't have to change any loadouts.
Well, I want to learn to do it myself too. So.
All right.
So I've got it up. So what do I do first?
Okay. So select what you want to use. So if you want to load missile racks, you're gonna pick a missile rack. If you want to do rockets, pick a rocket pod.
So do I select the rack first or the...
The rack first, whatever type of rack, either the rocket pod or the missile rack.
Alright, so let's go with this. The M261 2.75-inch rocket pod. Okay.
And then what you want to do is scroll down on the actual missiles selection and select a rocket that you actually want to use. You have to load the rocket into that space where it says no weapon first. Sorry about
that.
Okay. I'm following your question.
Load the pod in. What do I just drag and drop it? Or click that and hit load?
It's really hard to show you. So click the missile pod and then click where it says no weapon in the center. The middle center.
Oh, I see.
And then once it's popped up, do you see the four dashes to the right of it?
I do.
Okay, so now what you're going to do is select a missile or a rocket that you want to use.
Which ones are the flechette rounds?
They're towards the bottom. I think they're the second to last or the last ones. It'll save in the description.
Okay, found them.
Okay, and then click the dashes. You should only be able to load three of those dashes. The fourth one won't load.
Okay.
And then now just click the weapons bays you want to load them on, and then hit load.
So we'll do one and four. And then...
Keep in mind, every time you load it, it's going to completely wipe the loadout you had before. So if you want to do other rocket pods or missiles, you have to do it all in one blow and not try and series it up.
Okay. What kind of missiles do you want?
The L's are great.
Alpha, Charlie, Kilo, Lima...
Those are the laser guided, so they do lock on before and lock on after.
Okay. Anything in the dashes do I need to put?
Yeah, so you gotta load the launcher itself and then do the dashes for the missiles. Just like how you did the rocket pods.
Okay, and then dash, 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 and then I want to put that there and that there, and hit load. Weapons loaded, we're at 7,978. I'm gonna go to the outside view. Yeah. I can dig it. All right, let's go through these startup procedures here, ladies and gentlemen. Believe it or not, I am a very experienced pilot in ARMA, so we'll get her going here. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go down here, we're gonna turn our power on. If I can find the little button, there it is. Okay, I don't know if you guys hear click, but my MFDs have come up. His may have come up. It may take it a minute to get there.
It might not come up until the engines turn on.
Yeah. From there, I'm going to turn my alternate power unit APU on. Give that a second. You hear him start to spool up. And go ahead and start engine one.
I got MFDs.
Okay. Engine 2 start.
Now keep in mind, everybody, if you guys are watching this looking for a tutorial on how to apply this, you have to find custom user action 20 in your controls. And then that will allow you to actually interact with the cockpit. Keep in mind, that will also allow you to actually toggle and use things rather than scroll menu as well. So if you can find it in the cockpit, you can use it rather than having to scroll wheel.
Okay, so we've got power, we've got battery, we've got juice, we've got gas. Ready for prop clear. I'm going to do that. I'm going to turn my track IR on. I'm going to center it. Looking around. We are clear. Prop's clear. Engine startup. Maybe.
Did you turn your rotor brake
yeah,
off?
Yeah, one key factor here is I gotta turn my rotor brake off. There's my rotor brake, so now my rotor should spin on. There we go. And we will be off to the races here in just a moment. Okay, so this might be a little bit dizzying for you guys because I do fly with track IR, so bear with me. Say it again.
Can you look outside and see if the gun's tracking my head movement?
No, not moving. Alright, so we're going to turn a couple of things on for him. First thing we want to turn on for him is our FCR. FCR on. We're going to check outside. We're going to make sure that the flight control radar is rotating. It is. So we got rotation on the FCR.
Can you do me a favor? Is it looking now?
Yeah, it is.
Alright, so I'm happy.
Are you doing that with your track IR?
Affirmative.
Yeah, you'll have to show me that. So, what you guys are seeing right now is Hawkeye is moving that gun camera with his track IR. This aircraft comes with head tracking, so as he looks, the gun moves. So, that's kind of cool. Let me turn on my iPads, whatever you want to call it. iPads is on.
Copy that, I'm all spooled up, ready to go.
Copy that. Tower attack 1, we're going to go straight out departure. Target's 12 o'clock, 3.2K, on the other side of the mountain here. How do I get to your gun camera?
It's kind of buggy, but you can do HDUP NVS toggle.
Okay, I'll see if it works. 1.3K out, I'm gonna stabilize in an auto hover and see if I can get that gun camera to work. One, 12 o'clock.
Copy tally targets. I got a 3-man patrol running towards the buildings.
Yeah, clear to fire.
Copy engaging.
Yeah, that gun camera thing's not working for me.
Copy that. Yeah, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. It depends on the mood it's in.
Yeah.
We finally got the targets in the castle ruins. It looks like there's a couple teams of guys up there.
Copy that.
I see that squad of tactical goats on the mountainside as well.
Yeah, watch out for those fuckers.
Tanks earlier?
Just the one.
Hey, copy. I can't tell if this one's destroyed or not, so but. Be advised, I got eyes on BMP-2 as well as a two S9 Scorchers that. Arma 3 mobile artillery piece.
Copy that. What do you need me to do?
Copy, it's on our left. Let me get you a bearing. Advised bearing is about 260 R pause, 2.5 out.
Switch to missile.
Loaded.
Stable.
Yeah, I mean, let me boost my render distance here. Yeah, be advised, he's definitely to us right now, other side of the mountain. Let me do a pop up missile here, shoot it straight up, hit it down. Are you tracking my gun cam? It's to the right. Side of that mountain somewhere. Well, let me see if I can get eyes on.
So this here, what we're demonstrating is one of the best things about the radar on top, the longbow system. He's going to acquire this target. We're going to be able to sit back down. He's going to shoot up and down. So the missile is going to come out, go up, and then come back down onto the target. So it's going to be kind of cool. We don't even have to be there. They won't even know we're here.
And no eyes. I can't see him anymore.
Copy that. I'm going to come around the other side.
is, I see him now. Yeah, he is on my marker. Let me give me a grid ref here. He's sitting at grid ref 085042, and he's going to be Kilo Papa 8.
Go ahead and engage when ready.
Copy, I need about 40 degrees left. Yeah, he's way out there, about 2K out. I can't see him.
Yeah, I see you. I'm gonna move in on him. This crosshair of mine goes into the box, that means I'm onto your gun cam, right?
I believe so. Okay, I see him. I had to boost my object distance, that's why I couldn't see him before, sorry.
Copy, I'm gonna slow down.
Copy. If you can give me about, I don't know, 70 degrees to the left here, I'll be able to hit him.
Fire when ready. Holy shit, that's loud.
Yeah, I hit him once. Hold on 1 second. I'm gonna engage with guns.
Cover.
Just outside of LOS for me.
I can't tell at all what you're looking at, I'm sorry.
You should be able to see, if you got the sight up, you should be able to see my crosshairs.
How do I pull the sight up? Give me a second for a maneuver.
Roger. I got him now. He's right off our nose. You can't see him on your map.
I don't have my map up. I just have the mini map. Fucking little squad leader. I'm gonna cycle my left or my right MFD over to the radar.
Roger.
That might help a little.
Oh. Yeah, if you can give me a standoff and stabilize here, I can, if you angle me, I should be able to hit him with a missile.
Which way you need me to turn?
Give me left, almost 180. Yep, I got him now.
Stand by. Stable.
Got me firing. Boom. Hold on. Firing. He's moving. He's running.
Restabilizing, sorry. I was looking at your gun cam and I guess it takes auto hover off.
There's no auto hover on this one. It'll hover for like a split second, that's it. Can you give me 10 degrees to right?
Copy 10 right.
Alright. You can hold, it looks like we're drifting left a little bit. Copy, missile up. Hit his gun. Alright, I'm gonna fire one more. Yep, he's cooking off. I don't know if you can see that or not.
Okay, switch back to gun, look close. Looks like we got an infantry squad on radar.
Copy that, Brett.
Looks like direct front on the radar, check right MFD.
I got that BMPs out there. You want me to engage that?
Yeah, go ahead.
I realize I'm gonna hit him, hit him with a missile.
Got it.
Switching back again. Yeah, dismounts.
Yeah, it looks like a wedge formation right around that BMP.
Hey, are we tracking up or down or something? Because my gun's all over the place.
No, we're just sitting here. You got your laser on?
Affirmative.
Press T-Tango on your keyboard.
Ah, there we go. Thanks. You want to hit him with some of these full shot rounds?
Yeah, I don't know exactly where they're at, but...
Give me right about 5 degrees and come up right on that BMP. Nope, left a little bit more. Sorry, you were almost right on him. Left, 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 left. Right, look, he's in the tree lines to the right, right there. Right dead center, to the right. Right there, stop. Alright, go ahead and come in on that one. Rocket, rocket. Thank you. think it hits on those.
Nice. Stand by for maneuver.
He's passing low left there. You see him on the hillside? Right next to the water.
Eyes on.
That's my tally.
RTB and go buzz around in little birds.
Sounds good.
Where's Clint? We should go buzz him.
I don't think he's on the server anymore.
Oh. Pop chaff. I don't know how to shoot flares, so we're gonna die if it hits us.
I got knocked out. This thing's got that ECS jammer. I turned it on before we took off, so. It's got a nice little sound to it though, huh?
Yeah. bad boy.
I just realized. Hey, have you seen this? Watch him over this side.